so we're looking at hair change patterns here. And for her, right in the front, you can see right in between her eyes on the dorsal ridge of her muzzle. There's two right here. There is a line here. There's a line here that I can't help but to think that she wears a collar most of the time. And so you can kind of see that change in hair pattern right on the dorsal midline of her back right here. You can also see that right there as just kind of a permanent indentation of where her collar sits. She used to wear a harness, and she always kind of would turn around and kind of bite right here on either side. And there is a slight change in hair right here. And that could be, you know, her brachial plexus getting irritated right there, because it had a buckle on that right there on both sides. But moving down from her face, we see some pretty smooth coat down here, not seeing too many changes. There is a slight change right here. And there is a slight change right here, just over her ribs, where that hair is kind of flaring out. Good girl. There is a change right here, just on the cranial aspect of her thigh. She's got a lot of feathers, so I do see one slight change in her hair pattern where it's just running along her tendons on her forelimb right there. Good girl. I see another flare of hair just in her lumbar spine right here. And if I'm palpating along, kind of going and assessing her myofascial layers, I certainly do notice that she has some tension running in her rhomboids, kind of in her region of bladder 11 to kind of 13 in particular. And that kind of starts right where that hairline changes right there. And she is quite tense in this region, and she tends to be. So that is an interesting finding. But if I'm running along her spine and just kind of palpating, I can see her just flinched right there, and it's actually matching up with that hair flare right there. So that's something that we can focus on, and just trying to see if we can release some of that tension. And it is actually heating up under my fingers as I'm rubbing, just kind of back and forth. And we can even just do our effluage just through here, just to see if that helps that area. But again, back here, right in her caudal sacral region, or at the junction of her base of her tail right there, there's another little flare. That could be because she does flip her tail up a lot. But let's see if we can get her to flip sides. Yeah, so when I'm giving her a treat, you can see very clearly those marks on her face, where her hair flares up in between her face. And she does squint her, you know, she scrunches her face up quite a bit. So that could be a little bit of that. But here's another piece. Want to turn around? We can see a change in her hair right there. Her collar sits up here, so that's not really relating to that. But she does have elbow issues, and that I know, and that's definitely a point of tension for her that can be rubbed out a lot as well. And it just does kind of coincide with a different change in hair pattern. There's also, I'm noticing just a flare right here, and that's, well, I guess that's still at the top of her scapula as we're, and she just told me she didn't like that. She definitely is a little tight in that region, as she just kind of said, hey, leave me alone. So we can rub that. She just laid down, which is a nice sign that that's feeling pretty good. And move it a little closer. Hi, good girl. Yeah, good girl. And it is tight. I can feel a little bit of adhesions right at that cranial aspect of her scapula right here. Oh, you don't like that. Okay. We don't have to do that then. Yeah, so she's definitely tense. This shoulder region definitely is a little tight today for her. But she's pretty much telling me, no, don't touch that right now. So I'll respect that. Yeah, good girl. But it's something that we should address later, definitely. But that's all I'm finding.